Hi everyone, this is the demo video for the net worth tracker template. If you haven't purchased this template, I'll leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. When you purchase this template, the first tab would be an instructions tab. Here you can find my contact information as well as a step-by-step guide that will help you get started with setting up your template. When you get your template, it would look like this. The setup tab will be partially filled and the rest of the tabs, such as the annual summary tab, the cumulative tab, and the yearly tracker tabs would look like this because nothing has been added to it. For the rest of this video, I'll switch over to the demo tab to show you how the template works. All right, we are in the demo copy of this template, and the first tab is the setup tab. Here you would type in the currency. The default currency here is the dollar, but you can go ahead and delete that and type in your own currency. When you do this, it will update the currency symbol throughout the rest of the template. Back to the setup tab. In this area, you want to add in your net worth goals. Here is the year you can type in to start tracking your net worth. In the next column, you can type in your net worth goals. This template has been pre-designed to work from 2024 to 2023. However, if you want to start tracking your net worth in a different year, let's say you've purchased this template in 2025, and that's when you want to start tracking your net worth, that's fine. You can go ahead and change this year to 2025 and 2026. Select these two and drag it down, and it updates your template with the consecutive years. Now, if you do decide to change the names of the years here, all you need to do is ensure that the years here match the years here. So now that we have 2025 as our first year, go ahead and click on the arrow next to 2024, click on rename, and change this to 2025. And what it's saying is that it wouldn't change the name because we already have 2025. That's not a problem. Instead of doing that, we're going to work backwards. So go to 2033, click on the arrow, click on rename, and now we're going to name this 2034. And then work our way backwards, change this 2033. Okay, so we need to make sure that these names here match the names here. It's important to do this because the annual summary and the cumulative summary, these are dashboards, and they recognize the names here in order to pull information into the tab. And it's going to go based on the names here and the names right here. The next part of the tab is where you add your assets and your liabilities or your debts. Template allows you to add 8 different categories for assets. So for example, cash, retirement account, investment accounts, real estate, etc. And for the liabilities or debt, you also have 8 different categories. So things like mortgages, student loans, credit card debt, etc. Under each category, you can add up to 10 subcategories. The template will come with these examples, but you can go ahead and delete them or double click and type over it with your own information. The next tab is the annual summary tab. And after that, we have the cumulative summary tab. These are both dashboard tabs. So we'll come back to these after we go over the tracker tabs. So the first tab is 2024. And again, if you've renamed this, it would be called whatever year you've put in here. And it is a lot of information, but let's go over it section by section. The first area here shows you the year. So once you've renamed the tab in the setup area, so let's say this is now 2025. When you come over here, it will update automatically with that year. Like I said before, you need to change this manually to make sure the template recognizes the new tab name. The next area is your yearly goal, and this is the goal that you have entered for your network in the setup tab. Right here, we have the actual network for this year, and beneath it is a progress bar comparing your network to your yearly goal. And as you can see, we're at 99.4%. The next area here is a mini dashboard, and it displays your total assets, total debts, the starting net worth, which is the net worth that's calculated from the first of the month in January, your ending net worth, the one entered in December, your net worth goal, and your net worth growth. Now, let's say, for example, you don't want to start tracking your net worth in January. That's fine. Just leave these columns blank and it will pull your starting net worth from the first numbers that you enter into the first column. Similarly, so let's say you haven't entered your net worth till the end of the year in December, it will pull your ending net worth based on the last amount of money that has been entered into the columns. All right, the table here is a summary table for your total assets, and we have a similar table down here, which is a summary of your total debt. Moving on to how we enter data. The only place that you will be entering data in this tab is this area right here. Okay, you enter data here every single month for your assets, and you do the same every single month for your debt. That's it. Everywhere else updates automatically. And of course, you'll be entering data for your subcategory. You only need to do this once a year. So let's go ahead and delete some of these data so you can see how it works. All right, so I'm going to delete only for a few months, and you get the idea, because everything will be blank when you receive the template. The first step would be to select a subcategory. So let's say checking account is the first one. Once we do this, automatically the right category will appear here. If this is not matching up with the category, go back to your setup tab and make the corrections there. Let's assume you don't want the checking account showing up in this category. Go to the setup tab and remove the checking account from this category. So it's going to show up based on how you've organized the data in your setup tab. So going back here, let's say for January, our checking account has $6,000. Move on to the next one. Let's say our pension. And as you can see, it pulls in the right category. Now let's say that is $2,500. Okay, do this until you've added all of your subcategories for your assets, and then you move on to the debt and do the exact same thing. Now, let's say next month rolls around. You can add in all of your categories. If nothing has changed between January and February, you can go ahead and copy this, select it by clicking on your mouse and dragging down, and then right click to copy. You could also use the shortcut keys in your keyboard. Go to the next month, right click, click on pay special and values only. Once you do this, it pulls in just the numbers. It doesn't change the formatting or anything else. So that way you can easily update the information month after month. You don't have to go back and reselect any of the subcategories or the categories, except of course you need to change the name. Now, as you can see, when we scroll all the way down, this information is cut off, and it might make it difficult to know what accounts to update. So I'll make this a little bit smaller. And what we're going to do is freeze the rows. Go to the top end corner. You're going to see this area is slightly darker than the rest. So you can see a dark vertical line and a darker horizontal line. Click on it until it turns into this hand and click down. Drag it until you get to right here, okay? After the category. Now that we've frozen the row, you can scroll all the way down and you can still see the category and the subcategory. Moving on to the top area, which is your net worth, is essentially your asset minus your debt. And you can see that it automatically calculates this number every single month for you up here. And then we see the summary generated right here in this mini dashboard area. So that's essentially how the tracker area works. It's very simple. It takes just a few minutes to update every single month. When you're done with that year, you move on to the next year. And it's exactly the same thing. And of course, if you want, you can copy your subcategories from the previous year. Okay, so we're just going to copy that. Go to next year. Again, just assume that there's nothing here. And right click, paste values only. As you can see, it also pulls in a category. All we need to do is enter in all of the amounts for the month. That being said, let's move on to the annual summary tab. The first area is a year selection area. The way this works is when we select 2024, it's going to be looking for a tab named 2024, which is why we had to rename these tabs if you change the name in the setup area. Let's say 2025 comes along and you have updated the information for 2025. All you need to do is click on the arrow, select 2025, and it updates the entire template. Going back to 2024, you can see the total assets, your debt, your net worth, and how much your net worth has grown that year. Right here, you can see your net worth progress based on the goal that you set in the beginning of the year. And here you can see your asset breakdown, debt breakdown based on category. And here's where you see your net worth distribution for the entire year broken down by month. You can see a similar graph here for your asset distribution as well as your debt distribution. And there's two last graphs show you your subcategories. So you can see, okay, the retirement account is about 40% of your assets, and your largest debt is your mortgage. Moving on to the cumulative summary. So this is your multi-year tab. The way this works is that it shows you information for 1 year based on the year you select, and then it shows you information for all the years put together. So when you select the year here, so if I change it to 2025, it will change the information up here as well as the information in subcategory graphs over here. This information is year specific, and the rest of the information is cumulative. You can see that the net worth increased from 2024 to 2025 by 88,000 and by 500,000 from 2025 to 2026. Right here shows you your top assets over time. So for 2024, SEP IRA was the asset with the highest amount of money. 2025, it was a retirement account. And it does the same with your debt, showing you your top debt or liability across 10 years. Right here, we also have a summary graph, and it shows you your assets over time across 10 years. and you can see them in the graph here. Your debts over time across 10 years, and this shows you your year over year growth. So this information here is essentially the same as what you would get from this table right here. Moving on to this area, we have asset, debt, and net worth over time. So again, we have information for the first 3 years because that's the only tabs that have been completed. And here it compares your goal that you entered in your setup tab against your actual net worth. The line is your goal and the bars are your actual net worth. So when the bar is below the line, you're below the goal. When the bar is above the line, you have achieved or exceeded the goal for that year. And like I said before, this summarizes your asset subcategory and your debt subcategory, but it does it for the year that has been selected right here. That brings me to the end of this walkthrough video. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. You can reach out to me directly or through Etsy if you purchase this template through Etsy. And like I said before, if you have not purchased this template, I will leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.